Okay, so let's see first of all why we are doing this, why we are replacing this microwave with an engine. So let's do this vapor test. So right now I'll put the fan into boost mode, and this microwave has 400 CFM. But the problem with microwave is we have these two little filters. This whole area is open, and as you can see, it's very noisy, right? So it's very noisy. And what I've seen is in these US homes, the problem is they have given the bigger burners outer side. So the problem is you have these small burners which you don't use, at least for Indian type of cooking. And for quick frying, stir frying, everything, you kind of use these burners. And as you can see, this microwave running on full that delivers 400 CFM, it's not very good. And now we'll try something which is called microvisor hood. It's a piece of metal which kind of gets attached to this groove here, and we'll see the difference. So again, all the vapor is escaping it. And so when you cook, all the smell is also gonna escape. Okay, so here we are trying again with this microvisor hood. So now as you can see, this is really helping a lot, because it's kind of trapping all the vapor, and then eventually it's kind of able to pull it in. But I'm not sure if you will be able to see. Some part of it is still escaping. So at least with this simple attachment, which is like around $80, it at least don't allow the oil to go here. I mean, without this thing, we had a lot of oil accumulation here. So we cleaned it and then we installed it, and it has been a month almost, and then we don't see at least oil accumulation here. But as you can see, some vapor is still escaping. I think the fair thing to say is it's kind of covering 70 to 80% of it, but because some of it is still escaping, the smell of the food while cooking is still spread into the house, and that is why we are replacing this guy with the range hood. And once again, note down the sound, the noise at 400 CFM, which is the maximum this guy can provide. Okay, so this is how it looks after we remove the microwave. So the good thing is we have a rectangular space here, but the interesting thing is we have a circular opening here. I don't know why they did it, but it's very difficult to change, so we are leaving it like that. So microwave was actually sitting on top of this metal rail, and it was very difficult to remove it in this particular position, because this thing was getting stuck in the microwave when we were trying to bend it forward. So the thing is, there are two screws that goes on top, which kind of goes onto the microwave. So if you remove that, microwave kind of tilts forward. So ideally you should be able to tilt it enough, about 45 degrees, and then it should come out of these brackets. But in this position it was not coming out, and we really had to bend it to get it out. So after getting out, let's have a quick look at how it was. So as you can see, this was the opening at the back side of the microwave. And then let's have a look at this new range hood. So there indeed is an opening here, and if you remove this piece of metal, they have given one attachment to close this hole, and then we have to fix this hole here, and then we should be sealing this completely so that air is not escaping. So that's gonna be the tricky part. So somehow we need to put aluminium tape on top of this I mean this part somehow before you know fitting it there. So when we put the whole thing, we'll be having some space to put our hands on that. So with that little space to work with, we should be able to seal it from here. Otherwise we might have to go outside and do it from the outside, and from these two sides and from below it should be easier to seal. And we definitely need a hand jack to work with, so I took this car jack and prepared this platform from whatever thing I had. So this is one board and this is two piece of wood to block the car jack in place. And then I mean this can come out if you pull it like that, but it's right now it's kind of fixed between all these four sides. So this has prepared one hand jack for me to work with. Yeah, so this is after installing my new range hood. This is how it looks like. Just to give you a side view of how much ahead it comes. And now back to our rice cooker test. So right now this is not on, but still, because it's coming a lot ahead, it's still kind of trapping some of the steam. Not a lot is going out. And now let's try to run it on quiet mode. So it has quiet, low and high. So on quiet, it runs on 300 CFM. And remember, the microwave was running on 400 CFM at the max. So this is the result of 300 CFM. Still picking up. It kind of takes some time because it's quiet mode. And this is placed at the outer side burner, and then even the nozzle is placed at the outside. So now with quiet mode 300 CFM, this is how it's performing. Some steam is escaping, but it's really, really quiet. Okay, now let's try to put it on low. So it has 3 seconds, quiet, low and high. So let's see on low. So I think it delivers 500 CFM on low, and as you can see, it really is sucking all the steam in even on the low, and it's lot less noisy than on the highest mode of the microwave. As far as I can see, nothing is escaping even on the low mode. But let's still try to run that on the high mode just to see the noise. So on the high mode, it delivers 680 CFM. And as you can see, it really, really sucking a lot. I mean, it's not even allowing the vapor to form here, just disappearing here itself. So this is the sound on the highest, and once again on the low, which would be needed at the most of the times when we are cooking. And say after you're done cooking and then need to keep it running for some more time, they have this quiet mode. This quiet mode, it's really quiet. Yeah, still gives you sufficient suction if this thing were to be placed on the back burner.